We start with the stunning claims out of the latest January 6 committee hearing that Donald Trump tried to lead the deadly assault on the Capitol himself, lashing out violently when he wasn't obeyed.
This is the leader of the free world, and he is clearly unhinged.
It's astonishing. It's shocking.
This is a day that is going to loom very large in American history.
It was the most explosive January 6 committee hearing yet, and it was dominated by Cassidy Hutchinson.
As an American, I was disgusted. It was unpatriotic. It was un-American.
USA! The former White House aide offering disturbing evidence that, as bad as it was,
they are marching through now.
American democracy's darkest day could have been even worse.
USA! USA! We're going to walk down to the Capitol.
As a crowd of supporters gathered near the White House, Hutchinson claimed Trump tried to prevent the Secret Service from conducting weapons checks.
Where I overheard the president say something to the effect of, you know, I don't effing care that they have weapons. They're not here to hurt me. Take the effing mags away. Let my people in. They can march to the Capitol from here.
And after previously standing accused of fanning the flames of insurrection, claims Trump actually tried to lead the violent assault himself.
The president said something to the effect of, I'm the effing president, take me up to the Capitol now.
Even trying to commandeer the presidential limo.
The president reached up towards the front of the vehicle to grab at the steering wheel. Mr. Engel grabbed his arm, said, sir, you need to take your hand off the steering wheel. We're going back to the West Wing. We're not going to the Capitol. Mr. Trump then used his free hand to lunge towards Bobby Engel.
It was a damning portrait of a president unable to accept defeat, lashing out at the perceived betrayals of close allies.
It is very clear and very concrete. This was a president who led a coup d'etat and an insurrection against the people of the United States. It almost succeeded. We almost lost our democracy.
Incredible allegations and accusations now, this testimony that's come out from Washington and the aide, Ms. Hutchison there. Just to think about how potentially this could have been maybe even worse if Donald Trump, you know, the Secret Service officers and agents who were with him at the time where he's, you know, apparently grabbed the steering wheel from the back seat of the presidential limo after making that address and wanting to go join his supporters at the Capitol. Imagine if that was going to happen, if that took place.
And they would have thought, this was not in my job description.
Yes.
To stop the president trying to lead an insurrection at the White House.
It's also kind of refreshing to hear him be stopped doing anything. You know what I mean? In the narrative in my head of what his day-to-day life was at that time, was that no one would tell him no and he got his own way. There was another bit of unhinged sort of behaviour. I don't know if you saw the bit about him apparently threw his lunch against the wall, threw a plate against the wall. And I know this isn't what you're supposed to be focusing on, but someone just said there was ketchup, tomato sauce in our country, and I'm desperate to know what the lunch was. I'm thinking fish fingers.
Fish fingers.
I'm thinking potato gems. Yeah. I don't know why they won't tell us what he had for lunch.
Well, it's classified, ma'am.
Yeah. Classified.
But also, apparently it wasn't an isolated incident, that lunch thing. Apparently there was multiple times where there were tablecloths thrown and other items
really?
Items
All I know
thrown.
Is it must have been tiny plate.
Yeah. Looks like a little hand. Really little.
He went for the throat. Lucky he does have tiny hands. He just kind of like went for the throat.
Nice. Okay. Nice, actually.
But it is, I mean, what would have happened? Can you imagine if you let your mind go through, imagine if Trump had have gotten to the Capitol? We've seen how crazy it was. I mean, Mike Pence, I thought it was maybe, you know, a bit over the top that Mike Pence was in danger. Mm. You know, and then you see the scenes, you think, oh, no, he probably was in danger. But now the thing that Trump actually was okay with the mob going after Mike Pence is incredible.
There's part of me that will play devil's advocate here, and there's part of me that just thinks that if he had somehow got there, maybe the crowd would have flocked to Donald Trump himself, and maybe they don't even go into the Capitol.
So it would have just been a selfie fest, and they would have just forgotten about the whole revolution.
Possibly. Just as like a separate take, but I do think it's interesting that this is probably the first day of these hearings where we've probably heard the most explosive testimony that then could have ramifications down the track.
It feels like it's kind of going to stick now.
Yeah.
So that's what's interesting. There seems to have been a shift in the way Fox News was covering this, which is fascinating. So Fox were basically not covering it at all. And then today it was kind of, hang on. No, this is a big, powerful moment. This could be a game changer. And so I wonder if that's actually the most important thing that comes out of this. Because for the people who are not Donald Trump fans, there is absolutely nothing they're hearing now that will do anything other than confirm them in a position that already exists that doesn't make any difference. The people who matter here are the people who were supportive of Trump, or remain supportive of Trump, and that means the Republican Party, right? Because there's still this battle for the Republican Party's soul.
Well, it's still amazing that he's still the front runner. Yeah, I mean, that's amazing.
And that could change.
Yeah.
That could change after this. If you start seeing questions being asked on Fox News, even just wondering aloud, that's not where they were even yesterday.
Yeah. So,